What is going on, friends? We are back with Lysergic vs. Googly this time. And this is Googly's third game. He is 0-2 so far, and I think it's Lysergic's second game. Lysergic playing for US West, Googly playing for Oceania. And he brought this weird version of Stahl, or like interesting version of Stahl. In RYC, he was known to use his Umbreon Stahl. And yeah, let's see. I don't know if he made this Stahl team himself, or if he, like, or if he built it with other people. But yeah, Darktrio is there to prevent Mawile from destroying Googly. And also, if the Mawile doesn't have Fire Thing, I guess Scissor would check it too. But plus 2 Fire Thunder Punch would also do a good chunk to Scissor no matter what, even if he doesn't have Fire Thing. He gets up the rocks with the Lando. He did not go hard Zapdos, potentially fearing the Landers to have like Z Stone Age or something. No, he did have the Zapdos in. He did have the Zapdos in on the rocks, and then he switched it out. I assume he scouted for the Z Stone Age. So is he gonna U-turn on the Mawile? No, he just defogs. Yeah, he wants the rocks gone, so it's double defog, okay? I assume it's double defog. I did not pay attention if the Zapdos is pressure. But yeah, he's gonna go into Tangrowth slash Toxapex. Yeah, the damage on Landers is amazing. The damage is really nice on the Landers. Because it's the Rock Setter, and if the Rock Setter is gone, you already know rocks are gone for good, and they're not gonna go back up, even though he has this double defog core that will like help him to get rocks off anyway. So yeah, it's probably defensive Landers. He shows U-turn and rocks. He does not show lefties though. So I don't know if he's helmet or Z-move. I mean, usually I would think it's Z-move Tapu Bulu, and I still kind of think it... What, a Dragon showed U-turn earlier. I'm thinking it could be Specs Hydreigon and Scarf Keldeo. And Subtoxic Heatran, Sword Stance Mawile, or 4 attacks Mawile, I'm not sure yet. Did he show any attacks with Mawile? I don't think he did. He didn't make a evolve. This Clef is probably unaware. Doug is either Sash or Ground Z-move. Pretty standard. Tangrowth is just there to help versus like Tapu Bulu. Tangrowth and Scizor, the combination of those two, like helps. Versus the Bulu matchup. As we see Fire Blast into the Eject button, Toxapex. I did 14%. I just want to know if that's Specs or Scarf damage. Choice Scarf. Okay, it could be Scarf damage. I'm not sure yet. Probably Scarf then. That's really weird. So the Keldeo might also be Z move, but I'm still thinking it's the Bulu. If this is the Scarf or the. Like, the only reason I said it is because. If this is Specs, then the Keldeo is obviously a Scarfer. He has 28 to Zapdos, so we will calc that. Again, try to figure out. Wait, that does not. What does it do? So the Zapdos has some Spadef investment. It's definitely not Specs, it's basically what we confirmed from that Fire Blast doing that little damage. He could have conned the Crusher on this. So Googly is probably gonna go into Scizor or Tangrowth here. Not sure if he has Sludge Bomb on his Tangrowth. If he doesn't have, he will probably go into Scizor. I think Googly wins this game. He doubles out on Hydreigon with the Fire Blast, and Googly just has a free switch into Toxapex, so Mob Bali is probably gonna U-turn. And Mob Bali aka Lysergic. The thing is, what does he even U-turn out into? I'm not really sure. If he can win this matchup, like Mawile would put in work with the correct, like if he has Fire Fang, it would break through the Scizor pretty easy. But Fire Fang is not that common on Mawile. Actually, I like 4 attacks though. Like Thunder Punch, Thunder Punch, Blade Rush, Sucker Punch. and Fire Thing, or what was the last movie again that I liked? I think it was Fire Thing, but I don't remember. Yeah, he goes into Heat Twin. This could be this sub-magma storm set with Earth Power. He doesn't have a chance yet, I just realized. Interesting. But yeah, that's fine with me. I don't want to see that pink blob today. Let me just check real quick how far my latest upload is. 25%. Okay, okay. He doesn't get a burn, so he's Lava Bloom, which is interesting. Not. He basically tried to burn something. This might have Flash Cannon, but I doubt it has Flash Cannon because he showed U-turn and Fire Blast. So the last moves are gonna be Draco, Meteor, and Dark Pulse, obviously, because you want step on your Dragon, right? It was hard no more while the rocks go up, and he does not have hazard control. And his own rocker is at 28 after rocks. He's gonna try to get his rocks up later on, like he has to try to get up rocks. So Googly has to defog for Lysergic. What did he do for Wish? Go for Wish or Flamethrower? Well, it's interesting. He did not burn it, but he gets damage off on this. There's a Gen 2 game that has been going on forever. My computer lags when I click on it. I don't know why I clicked on it. That was a big mistake. Let me just click on this black-white game real quick. I see you did win, okay. So you did finish 2-1. Look at this game. It's a turn 574 and it's 6 versus 5. But yeah, let's go back to this game. I assume it's gonna go Scizor or Toxapex here. He just stays in. Okay, so he's willing to let his Clefable get weakened to kill the Morwall. I mean, Morwall was the main threat to his team, so it's understandable. I think Scizor would have been a fine play there, but it worked out anyway because he got rid of the Morwall. So like, maybe his Calmind taunt. Maybe a Calmind taunt kill you can put in some work, but I'm pretty sure he's not that set. Maybe he's double Scarfers. I'm not really sure. He could be double Scarfers because that did 8-16. I'm pretty sure that mob just loses this game, but I'll see real quick if that Scarfer specs damage. Where's Kaleo? Sure, Scarf. That's got us 15 to 17. So what happened to you? There was something in my room, so I was a bit, I was not really paying attention. Switched out into Hydreigon on a Scald. Toxapex switched out into Tangrowth on the Dark Pulse. Took 29. Is that AV Tangrowth? That didn't do much. He just went for Hidden Power Ice. And Goody's just gonna go in a Scizor here. There's no reason to play any risky, right? The rocks are obviously huge for Googly. I'm thinking here what Mob could do. If the Scizor has U-turn, he can just click U-turn to get momentum because on the incoming heat turn. Or an incoming Keldeo. It goes Landris instead, so that makes me think that he's Rocky Helmet. Goes in a Zapdos, so this is probably a fast Zapdos. Is it fast with like HP Ice? I mean, you can probably tell from the Landris that it's how the Landris has been played and how much damage it has done. You can probably tell that the Landris might be defensive. He gets a Flash Fire boosted Lava Plume crit. So he weakens the Zapdos, which is like, it's nice and all that, but I still don't think he's gonna be able to win because there goes his Heatran. We see it's lefty, so it doesn't have Shed Shield, so it's dead to this Earthquake. And And yeah, I don't think there's a point, like, continue playing for Mob, but he's gonna do it anyway for his team, which is understandable. Maybe Dark Pulse crit flinch everything. Maybe that might be the play. I assume he's just gonna U-turn. I mean, he's just gonna go Toxapex, right, Googly? He can also sack off his Clefable. Oh, he stays in on... I don't know if he predicted the U-turn. But yeah, he doesn't really need his Duck Trio this game, does he? I don't think he really needs his Duck Trio. He did Stone Edge and he did crit the Landorus. I mean, that didn't matter. If it didn't kill, it would've 2-8 KO'd. But yeah, one sec, I gotta pause it real quick. Okay, so Mob still didn't send anything out. Which game are they talking about? I think they're talking about the Gen 2 game, yeah. Like, I don't really see what he can do, because if he goes out in the Keldeo, it just gets walled by Toxapex, Tapu Bulu gets walled by Scizor. And Tadragon also gets walled by, like, Toxapex, unless it flinches. Toxapex is basically, yeah, it's at full. It says 72, but it has Regenerator, so it's at full. Okay, so he sacks the Zapdos, potentially. So he did not save the 6-0, which is, like, fine. He doesn't have to. You can just go Scizor and click Bullet Punch or U-turn, like... I guess he can Roost. I forgot that he was at 66, so it makes sense that he sacked the Zapdos first, in case the Bulu had like a specific Z-move. But because this wasn't at full, so that makes a lot of sense that he didn't go hard to it then. He just doesn't want to risk anything. Because like some specific Z-move might have killed with a crit or something. You can just click HP Ice here. Sex of the Clef, so he's playing it super safe. Goes to Scizor and clicks U-turn or Bullet Punch. At least this game was pretty fast, because I gotta eat, got some stuff to do. I don't know if there's more games. There's probably gonna be eventually another game, because they have to play like 56 games or something like that in like the next 20. Oh, he just went Toxapex. Okay, so he's just gonna click Scald then, or Toxic. Okay, yeah, I was thinking like if you have Toxic you click that, if you don't have Toxic, if you have T-Spikes instead, maybe Scald was the better play. But yeah, Toxic is obviously fine for it. This Bulu is gonna die slowly. He spams Toxic in case he wants to go Keld. Super power up doing absolutely nothing, and yeah. We haven't seen stall in a while, like I haven't seen many stall today, maybe one or two. Yeah, that was one, there was a stall, I didn't really record that. But it was only 46 turns, which is funny. It is comment. The Bulu never showed Z move, right? So maybe the Z move is on the Keld. If he had Taunt, maybe the Keld you could have put in some work. But yeah, that's the Z-move Calmine said, and Breakneck Blitz doesn't even kill. Does a good chunk though, and the Pex might die here. Yeah, the Pex dies. But the Keldeo is too low now, so he can just click Giga Drain. And yeah, Secret Sword won't do enough, and Keldeo is gonna die. Even with a crit, it doesn't do enough. As the Mob is, I think, 0-2 now, and Googly is 1-2. And Mob is playing for US West, which is, they are 12-14 now, and Oceania is 5-15. So I think, I don't know if that was the first game that Oceania won in Sun Moon. I think it was. But thank you guys for watching, and you know what's going on my channel. I will be back with more World Cup coverage later. So peace out, friends.